Right. So what's this, like a sheep barn?
It's a sheep barn. It used to be a sheep dipping barn.
And this is the bits you want to get rid of, potentially?
Potentially. It's just been used as a dumping ground for lots of bits and pieces for years. Now, that's sat in a junk box for many long years.
It's an electrified oil lamp. In a nice base, actually.
Is it?
Yeah, it's all right, that. It's okay. The lamp is one of those things that I'm going to have to spend some money on, but it's more time. The rewire is going to take minutes and cost a few pounds. We've got the materials, we do it in-house. The cleaning of it is slightly trickier, to not over-egg it, overdo it, basically. The base is good, and I don't want to clean that too much and lose that patination that it's taken decades, you know, to acquire.
Made in the late 19th century, the base of this lamp is Japanese in origin and still bears traces of the original gilt finish. Originally an oil-burning lamp, over the years it has been repaired and converted to gas, and more recently electricity. Carefully and sympathetically restored, it could be worth around £550.
A big crack in it there. Great big crack all the way around.
What about all the other cracks?
This is sort of crazing that one to the glaze.
Is it painted? Or?
It's hand-painted, yeah.
Yeah.
So it's a 19th century or earlier vase,
mm-hmm.
and lastly converted to oil and then converted to electric. It's actually quite nice.
Is it?
Yeah. I think you're looking at it with different eyes now, aren't you?
Yeah,
I have. I thought so.
It's just been languishing.
But for that little thing, even with the crack, I'll happily give you £300.
A little bit more?
I've just remembered, Ron, is your father a farmer?
Yeah, I'm the farmer.
Always the farmer. Farmers, isn't it? Yeah. Always farmers, you're always...
You've got no chance. You've lost
money.
Already.
All right, £350, that's it, done, finito.
Okay.
Deal?
Yeah.
Thank you. It's very nice, but that could have easily got thrown away, couldn't it?
It could have.
Yeah. Price-wise, paid £350. Let's say in time and effort and materials, we're going to spend £50-60 on it, and it should retail between £550, somewhere around there. We're not making a fortune on it, but it doesn't matter. We'll have a very nice, happy customer, that's for sure. You had a big house around here, didn't you?
Yeah.
It was demolished, so that would have come from there?
I think so, yeah. I think that would have been one of the only things that was retained.
Probably. What about
and
this?
And that, and I think that too.
This one is not worth as much as that.
Yeah.
Even though they're quite common, it is on leather.
But it's never... I've never seen a use for it.
They look really good hang on a wall. That's the only thing you can really do with
them. OK, well, that's giving me a new idea with that.
Oh, bugger.
Before you go and offer me something silly.
That's what I do with them. And then it gives them a sort of another life, really.
Because you'd never use it as a screen now, would you? Unless you have a stripper in your dining room or something like that.
Ideally.
You've got loads, haven't you?
I'm having the pole fitted at the weekend, actually. I think it's upside down as well. Well, it is upside down. I'm going to flip it round. It can't be upside down because the frame's like that.
Oh, well, maybe they put it on my grandfather put it on the thing the wrong way up.
It's the wrong way up.
So that's hand-painted on leather.
So what they do first is they make all these shapes into the leather and then it's painted and gilt. And this has been overpainted as well. It's unusual in two respects. One, I think the embossed leather is upside down. And number two, it's only twofold, which is really unusual. They're usually 3-4 minimum, so a little double one. And it hasn't been trimmed down either. That's how it's always been.
Leather screens were a popular addition to European homes from the 17th to early 20th centuries. Originally designed for privacy, they were also decorative and often featured motifs such as birds or floral arrangements. This one was made in around 1860 and has a gilded design with hand-painted flowers. It could be worth around £550.
What about a bid the same as the lamp, £350?
What would you sell it for?
£550.
So then you should go to £400, really?
Ideally not, no. I need to make some profit. That's what I see it on the shop floor at £550, because it's got a couple... It is a little odd that it appears to be upside down.
I am a farmer, remember?
I know. 375. Fine, sold. I'll take it. Paid $375 for the screen in the end. That's fine. We've got a little bit of work to it, not much. We'll hang it on a wall and it'll retail well. $450, $500, somewhere around there, I think. Well, there you go. I can see something already in there, like the chair in the far right corner.
The one in the cane one?
Yeah.
Yeah, used to sit in my granny's dressing room. There's we put on. I think this.
I'm more interested in what's inside it.
I think it's green, as far as I remember.
Because it changes the value if it's got the original seat cover. See? It's been sat in underneath a dripping tap by the looks of it. Yeah, that's the original. That's the original cover.
Is it?
Yeah. Needs work, again. This needs completely repolishing. It's gone very,
yeah,
very flat.
Yeah.
There's a big lump being chipped out of it there and then stuck back on. This will sound quite harsh, but in its current state, because of the damage, £150.
Yeah, I think I'd probably hold on to it at that.
Yeah.
The value to me is thinking of my granny sitting in it.
Yeah.
So I really ought to do it up and put it somewhere where you can really notice it.
And there's a few interesting pieces, but there was a Berger armchair there with a really nice high sort of spoon back to it. But there was a repair on the back, which I can't get away from. And also Joe has a, you know, an attachment to it. I never want to take things off people that have that, because that's really what things are really worth.
Having explored the farm and the items Joe has for sale, the boys have been invited to enjoy a special treat before they hit the road.
Good evening, sir.
This looks very nice. So, come on then, talk me through this.
We have a bramble, which is cassis, gin and lime juice, a bit of sugar. What do we think? Is that a winner?
Oh, yeah.
The last one's a Kira Royale.
Which is this one or that one?
This is mine. This is soda water.
Van-friendly.
Yeah.
Yeah. This is very nice. I didn't realise you'd
jump ship
now.
Oh, yeah, I've been branching out, yeah. The company's much better in this job, I think.
You're sick of driving the van?
Yeah.
That's very good.
Oh, that's actually really good as well. You made a mess there.
The day was so interesting. I never dive in at the first offer. I'm a farmer, so I'm used to wheeler dealering, and certainly if you come in at one level, I'm definitely going to come in above.
Joe was really nice to deal with all day. The things I bought were great. The screen, fairly standard-ish thing, but super decorative. The buy of the day was the Japanese vase lamp. It's going to need a little bit more work than I thought, but it's quality. All in all, a fabulous day. So that was an excellent little haul. That lamp does bear a little bit more investigation. It's really very good. That screen will be in about 5 minutes and be gone for sure.
Back in Conwy, Jew's latest purchases are unloaded at the new warehouse.
Good afternoon.
How are we doing? Isn't that nice?
Where have you been? Spain?
Witten Estate in Herefordshire. There's a distillery on site.
A distillery?
It is, yeah.
Oh, so is there plenty of drinky poos?
A little bit. There was the cassis, English cassis is their speciality.
So bar drinking, you've come back with this.
Yeah.
I mean, gone are the days of screens being used to, you know, hide behind and then throw your stocking over. The screen is embossed leather. It's very cleverly done. This could be used as wall art or in a retail environment.
And so is this.
Let's have a look. How cute's that?
Yeah, it's lovely. Do you know, I hadn't noticed that till you put it down.
How cute is that?